String parts are next. Okay. Let's take a look at what we have. Many good things. Now, usually in the string parts, it's more difficult to find rests for each, at the bottom of each page. Sometimes that's not possible. And I mean, this is not really obligatory, you know, for every page, but it's something that I'm really trying to do. So if that is possible, or at least every two pages there has to be a spot for the page turns. So okay, I'm seeing this rest here. Of course that would mean that all of this would need to be modified. If I move this three bars to this line, that kind of will break the layout, which will mean that we need to do manual adjustments. So basically, let's see. Okay, well, just looking to find possible spot to do the a little adjustment, which won't require too much work. So how about if I put this bar on the last line? Then I'm gonna move this to this page, this line to this page, and then also gonna have, alright, so I'm gonna leave it as it is here. I'm gonna try to place this side, this page on the left side. And this will be on the right side, the turning side. So let's get this. And this system on the next page. I'm seeing something here. I think this is the. This is the to be able to play on the same, I mean without the DVZ. Yes, this is the sign here, so let's suggest that. Okay, all right so I guess now we can drag this system down and let's space this 7 to 14. Let's try. This is not bad. Okay. This actually looks okay. And let's take also a more attentive look at the last page here. All right, not bad. So I think because of this little changes I just made, I think it's possible to keep, you know, this intact. Another option would be, as I mentioned, to get this three bars on this page, have the rest, rearrange this everything. So that would be another option, but I think that this could work. Yeah, especially if I place this page on the left side, and then this will be on the right side, the page turn. Yeah. All right, so now let's take a more close look to what we have here. So on this page, I would like to have the system a little bit closer, less white space. So less white space. Let's see if we can use the same. I'm gonna try. Okay. I wanna see if I could select. If I could select the systems, would the, yeah, it would get the right numbers. Yes, that's good. So I don't have to put this all the time in. I could first select the systems, and it will get those bars, or it won't. Let's see.
Yeah.
Maybe I'm wrong. Would be nice if it could do that. So I just selected the lines. No, it doesn't have that option. Okay, no worries. Just checking. Okay, what if I press OK? Let's see. This is pretty good. Now this was a little bit, to my taste, too much white space here. So this looks a little bit better. I used to have dotted 8 notes here, and I kind of like that more than this, so I think I'm gonna change this to a dotted 8 note. Yes, and most other places I can see they have the dotted 8 note, so alright, so I was talking about this making the dotted 8 note instead of this, because in the score, I think in the similar spots, other instruments, I do have that. So now I don't know an easy way to do this apart from selecting the quantization and allow. Let me show you how this works again. So without selecting this quantization settings and right here allow data to rest in simple meters. Now I don't want that because if you check it, I guess the half not rests will also be dated, and that's really really not a good idea. So this is not an option for me. So I don't know any other way to make a quick change for like to merge this rests without selecting that option that I just mentioned. So let's do it manually, and if anybody who's watching knows how this works or knows a script that would do this, that would be really helpful in this type of situations. Okay, so okay, I'm just gonna have to change it. So I do edit that before erasing the 16 note, just in case, so I don't break something with the rest of the bar. Okay. There is a similar spot toward the end of the piece, and here it's good. This is nice. Okay, not consistent though. Let's see, this is the only spot with that rhythm in this piece, so I just want to see the score to check the other instruments if they have similar problems. No, I don't see this issue. Okay. And then at the beginning, let's check one more time this other instruments. Right, so yeah, so I'm not quite sure why it defaulted to the two rests instead of the merged rest. Maybe when I copied the violin part, something changed. Yeah, so the rest looks the rest of the parts that have the same rhythm looks good. Okay, so let's go back to the violin one. Let's continue. All right, with the editing. So okay, we have some issue here. Okay. plenty of space. Not a fan of this kind of stuff, but in my view, this line is a little too close to the notes. I think also the problem with the rests is also because I deselected the option before I run the, I mean, when I was running the plugin, I deselected the plugin to look into the rests thing, so it's very possible that this, I wouldn't even have to deal with this if I would just leave it with the standard options. Okay, so let's see. I was looking at this the legatos. Yes, that's the first page. Let's keep going. The second page. Okay. Now, to me, this looks a little bit. It may look a little bit too crowded. Too much stuff. Let's start moving around things. Definitely readable, but don't quite like. I think also I did move something, I believe. Or maybe not. If I didn't move anything from here, then I would definitely think this is a bit too much stuff, too many bars. Six bars or five bars probably would be the best for a comfortable reading. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. In a bar, in a place like this, I guess 5 bars. I could, of course, just run the locks, the unlock systems, and that would arrange it again, you know, because I'm just gonna keep doing this. More bars, more measures will pile up like this. So I guess we're gonna have to see if we can change this a little bit. So before I do this, I wanna have this rest at the end of this system. So what if I send this on the next system? Okay, this looks a little bit too crowded. This wouldn't work. Yeah, it's a little bit too much. Well, maybe this would be the solution to the layout on this page. Okay, moving on to, I'll be back, of course, to check on things, but let's first look at the arrangement on the systems. So, how about if I unlock this? Good. Think this is not bad. Right, and now let's take a look at the placement and everything else. So first page looks okay. Second page. Okay, we have something here. This is good. Next page. Too much space here, maybe. Let's see. I think it's pretty good. We have rest. And the last page. To raise the bow. normally it should stack automatically. Maybe this is an old file, and this is why there is a problem. So let's see. Adjustments. Just a little too much white space for me. Maybe not in this part, but here. Okay. Alright, that doesn't look bad. Okay, moving on to Valence 2. First, let's take a look at the way the plugin dealt with the challenges in this score. This part here. That's not good. Okay. Yeah, but in general, not bad. Just a little bit too crowded, just for my taste. A little bit too crowded. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. It's readable. Yeah. No, I could just leave it the way it is, and I think it's fine. This is not good. Yeah, alright, so we probably will have to do some changes because of this. Because of this. Okay, and this kind of changes quite a lot. I have to move this bar because this is so tight, everything. I'm gonna have to reposition all the bars, I think. Let's try it, because this there is no other way. I mean, doing something like this I guess would be possible, but let's do it with the hard way. Bars is enough. That would be too much. I start doing this, I don't have any rests. That is a problem. So maybe the solution that I had before I start making these changes, maybe it was really the best to get that rest. Let's see. Maybe I would just make a note that I couldn't have a rest here, so at the end of this page I'm gonna have a rest on the next page. So let's see. Okay. Another option. What if I could move this to this this page? That's possible. I could have more space here, just enough for this line, maybe. That could be possible, so let's see if we can rearrange the first page. Let's see how it looks. Okay. Alright, doesn't look too bad. I'm gonna check it one more time for things like this. But this looks fine. And we have a big rest. We have a big rest at the end, which is nice. Okay. Okay. So unlock this. Okay, that's pretty good. I will correct things that I don't like. So now, would it be possible to have possibly this line here, and then maybe the three lines on this page? Not that I'm trying to save space, but I think it could be possible. Let me save this. And then let's see if we have space for one more system. Okay. All right, this looks a little too much here, but we can adjust that. It's fine. Okay, maybe there are a few other moments, but I think this is a possible. A possible solution. Deal with the other problems. Right after I fix this thing here. It's definitely not good. Okay, well, this is probably it. And now, let me take a look at what I can do here to fix things. So, again, the reason why I'm doing these manual adjustments after the perfect layout plugin, because it was a little bit too crowded, and somehow the rests, maybe the plugin didn't find the you know, ideal solution, which is almost impossible to find. I guess the option that we had at the beginning when we just started doing this, the option that the plugin had was pretty decent. I just think it would be great to have an option to react a little bit better to the spots with a lot of notes. It was still readable, everything. It's just did look a little bit too crowded, so okay. We have something here. I'm doing the right thing. Here it is. The rest looks okay. Next page. This, of course, I need more space here. Now, this is like a little strange situation. Only 7 bars, and this is 33 bars, so it's a little strange. This takes more space than this, but again, all these changes were after I made my corrections, so I can blame the plugin for this. Okay, now this takes a lot of space here. I don't think there's any other option. Okay. All right, this is not bad. And now, the last page. Yeah. this part does look like a little cramped in some parts, in some sections. A little bit higher. What about, okay, here it is. This is not bad. Okay. 2, 3. Yeah, not sure why it's still here. This thing. The other page didn't go away yet. It'll go away. Okay, it went away. Good. So yeah, so we try to fit how many systems? Four, 9 systems. That's a little bit much. 4, 9. Nine systems. Okay, so let's see a few other moments here that need some adjustment. Is pretty good, decent. Okay, moving on to the violas. All right, let's check it out. This is good. This one. Fine. Now I don't like so much white space, but can fix that. Now to me this looks a little bit too crowded again. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 bars. This is good. All right, but because of this we'll have to change things. Okay. Now again we have this issue as well. Which doesn't look very good. Oh. Few adjustments. Alright, this is, I think, better. We'll just have to deal with the white space later. Now what can we do here? So I'm gonna move things around. I'm gonna rearrange this. Maybe even add another page. The spacings if necessary. I can see the logic here. I mean, this is the rest, and I mean, this is, yeah, the rest, but this doesn't really work. This tempo change too long. So let's do this break. Yeah, I'm going to try to respace this and see if, even to the point, as I said, I'm gonna probably add another page here. So, what if I can this put these three lines on the first page in some way or the other? Let's see. Maybe. All right, let's make some space on the first page. Okay. All right. Before I do this, page break. Move manual adjustments. So I need these three lines on this page. Is that, if that's possible? Let's see. Okay, I guess something like this. Like this. Yeah. This is good. This is fine. Okay, and now I may have to rearrange things a bit here, so no. Let's remove the blocks. Ideally, I would want this to be on the next page, probably. So, see if an adjustment. Okay, I think I overstretched something here. No. Okay, maybe like this, yeah. Looks a little bit too busy here. Don't like that thing, so probably this way. Okay, I guess again we'll deal with the other parts later. Let's see what we can do here. Okay, this the default spacing looks pretty good. The finale default spacing, so I just have to adjust things, but yeah. So yeah, we have a plan here. I guess this works now here. Guess same, doesn't make a big difference anyway. So now a spot like this, I don't like it. Okay, I don't like it when something starts like in the last bar that doesn't look logical. This part right here. Too much. Okay, there's a lot of adjusting that I have to do. So let's begin with the first page. Let's space it first. This one right here. Like reduce to second page. Let's check that first. Okay. More space. looks a little strange. This, we can fix it. We can fix it really easily. So, I know why. Okay, so because of this, because of the long name, that's why this is so long. So maybe this way, at least it doesn't look so bad. This would be fine. Maybe there's an option to make the rests, multi-measure rests, longer because of the tempo marking, which is extra long. Okay. Not bad. So, how many systems? 1, 2, 3, 4, 2, 3, 4, 9 systems. Yes, it's a lot on one page. It's good. I guess it's decent. Readable, but I'm gonna move this, yeah, this system to the next page, obviously, and in a way we will have more space. Yeah, I'm not sure why I didn't do that earlier. So how about if we space this page? This is 10, 17. 10, 17. Oh. All right, something didn't go well. Let me try that again. So. Yeah, that's fine. I was a little afraid of this action, but let's see if I like this spacing, and I don't really like some of the spots, so I can adjust it a little bit on my own. Like, yeah, doesn't look too much space in some parts. You know, another way to do this maybe a little better would be to, if I'm gonna leave it like that, what I do want to do is erase all the manual adjustments and then do the other spacing. But I think this is okay. So you can never get bored. There is a lot of different ways to do the same thing, and you can choose how you want to get there. So, alright, so this looks pretty good. Moving on to the next page. Okay. It's going to hopefully lose this white page here. Okay, here it is. This looks pretty good. How about if I just space it? Yep. A little bit, maybe. Okay. too high. Okay. So I think this looks good. Going to the next part now. Two more. The cello and the double basses. Okay. Okay, now here we have some Q notes and we have to fix those rests. That's easy fix. Before we do this, let's see the arrangement on the page. This is good. Okay, so it managed to put all the bars, everything, all the way to the end on three pages. But I guess here we have that place with the rests. It's my fault again. I probably the old file issues. So let's fix that. I'm gonna change that to default rests, and this as well. And now, and how about this? Okay, I'm gonna have to look at this system. This is pretty good. All right, let's fix that rest. Now I can adjust this tie. There are three notes, so I guess the easiest way to do it would be to do it with the simple method. I guess this one also needs to go something like this, and in this part as well. Okay, maybe it's a little bit too much white space on this page. Before I do this, let me see what the systems 1 through 7. Okay, let's try this again. Maybe it will work this time. No, it doesn't catch the system numbers. A little bit, we did something a little bit, but maybe let's see. Do we like this? Yeah, this is good. This is fine. Second page. This is good. good. Now here, what if I move this on this next line? I'm gonna have to do some adjustments, but it's probably best to do that. I'm gonna fix a few things that we moved around. So yeah, that's, or too stretched. Okay. Now these bars, they look huge. It's okay. There are many notes here, so it's fine. Alright, let's see what else can we do here. Yeah, I guess this could work. This could work, and gonna need to make adjustments. Let's see. We'll start from the first page. Okay, right here. That's okay. This is not bad. Second page. Okay. Yeah, it's all okay. No real need to adjust anything that I see here. It would be possible to move this one to this line. Yeah, I guess. Alright, and the real issues I have here on this last page, so let's take a look at that. I still want to move this a little bit down. Okay. Yeah, there are a lot of notes here, I guess. Oh. A lot of systems. 1, 2, 3, 4. 10 systems. Oh. I of course would move this to this page, but I really want to have the rest, so I keep the rest. does look a little crowded. Okay, let's fix this. I guess when the tempo mark, that's the beginning of the system, and there's a tempo, it's like a meter change, yes, so the tempo needs to be right here. That's visually, that looks more organized. So a little bit low here. Still, I guess it will print out so on the page. I don't think this is a problem, but how about this one? Alright, I think we're done with this one for the moment, and moving on to the last part in the strings, double bass. Okay, interesting, where is it? Double bass part, here it is. Okay. Similar spot to the cello, I guess. Yeah, and then again we have this problem with the rests, which is totally my fault. Okay. This is good. Alright, how about the first page? If we can remove a little bit of the white space, maybe that would be a good idea. I don't see any results of that. Let's try this again. Okay. All right. So that works. Now again with the ties, same idea. Gonna change to fourth voice. A script that moves everything over or under, but in this case I can't use it. Okay. All right, so the first page, fine. Moving on. Okay, so I don't like this spot. I don't like this is so busy. And this is a little bit too busy as well. So let's see if we can fix it. I'm gonna still keep it on too long. Ah, of course we have to fix this. The bars. Default rests, and these two. Okay. I want to see there's this spot in the cello part. All right. This is, I think I forgot to do this here, so okay, better. Not sure why my parts are not in order, probably because again this is a very old document. Okay, now here, let's do the same. So, create. Okay, so we're gonna be changing things around these two pages. So, we don't need so many changes though. Ah, okay, well this one definitely. Okay. Alright. So let's make this look better. I still have to adjust the white space, but let's see what's happening on this page. Okay. That's pretty good. Maybe I will do this. Maybe. Yeah. But maybe a bit too much though. I wasn't patient 10 years ago, even 5 years ago, not as patient as I am now with this mechanical tasks like this. I probably wouldn't be able to survive doing this type of thing. So I guess with a little age, you know, we become more patient. So I remember that this type of tasks were the most unpleasant for me out of everything, so I guess when someone compares the creative aspect of being a composer, but then there is this aspect, the technical tasks that I guess one has to do unless they hire somebody else to do it, Now this technical thing was always like a big unpleasant thing for especially for young people. This is really not many people can take the time and have patience to complete all this, especially in this few videos I'm recording. I'm only doing it for the third movement, and this is not a very difficult, I mean this is not, it's not a very busy composition in terms of the writing for the orchestra, but in an orchestral piece with a lot of writing and all kinds of, this is a very accessible sort of kind of piece, but in a large orchestral work is a lot more more things, and this is just the third movement. Multiply by this by three to get a sense of how much time it takes to do something like this, the parts and the score. So yeah, it's quite a lot. So let's see. Okay, so I'm just going to space this later, but right now adjusting what I can. And now on this page, let's see if this helps. So I think the last page was pretty good. Okay, and now let's see the second page. Okay. On this page, I'm going to arrange it a little bit differently. So let me add. I'm gonna add a page break here, just in case. And I'm going to respace this most regular way possible. Okay, one more time. Okay, now there's a lot of white space, so 8 to 15. Yep, that helped a little bit. Okay. Alright, so let's take one more look at this. Okay, here it is. I'm gonna check this bar also for the other string instruments, just in case. In case I missed the bow marking here. So how about, alright, let's check the cello here. Yeah, it's good. This is the violas, the violin 2 and violin 1. Okay, good, no problem here. Alright, going back to the double bases, and let's see if there's anything else I wanna change. Here maybe. This is okay. This is okay. I'm seeing there's more space here, so I can definitely put this, get it down here a little bit more, like this. Okay. Yeah, that looks pretty decent. Alright, so just to sum everything in this step that I did, this was the fine tuning after I ran the Pivot Layout plugin, and I just want to say that I'm really happy with the help that I got from the Pivot Layout on this. The only thing I noticed was mostly because of my fault with the rests, because I deselected that option, so the plugin didn't do any corrections about that, and just a few times maybe they were especially in the strings, it looked a little bit too crowded in some spots, so I didn't want to make it look a little bit more spacious in some spots. But and if I have to do that, that whole layout basically is in that section, it goes to the trash, so I have to sort of, not everything goes to the trash, but a lot of those nice changes that the plugin makes, if I move things around, then I have to adjust them, those spots manually. Okay, but the rest was pretty good, so alright, I guess the next step would be for me to look at the second movement, which I'm going to do on my own, and then after that I will probably record a video about the final step, where I merge the PDFs of all three movements and I place the page numbers and the way I do that process. So that will be probably the next video after I am gonna have to complete now the second movement, the parts and everything. So excellent.